Welcome to yet another event by Hi TV, and today we are here at the Fellowship Night of SLAP Sri Lanka. Come with me as we see what they have in store. With me, Azra Rialdin, President of SLAPS. How are you feeling today?
Wonderful, Isri, thank you.
Can you just give us a little brief introduction on what SLAPS is, the history and the significance of tonight in particular?
Yeah, certainly. So talking of SLAPS, that's basically the shortened form of our association. So we are called the Sri Lanka Association of Administrative and Professional Secretaries. So we have been in existence for the last 46 years, founded by late Mr. Eric De Silva. And talking of the association, I would say we are the only registered association for administrative and professional secretaries in the country. And we are also affiliated to the Asia-Pacific Secretaries Council. So we do a lot of activities starting from January. And we are involved in a lot of training and development. We also do a lot of sessions for towards the profession. And today, so as you can see, we are conducting the Secretary of the Year contest, which has been, which we have been conducting since 1998. But sadly, since 2014, we were unable to hold this. So it's after a lapse of 10 years that we are conducting this, and we are quite excited and thrilled to see how it goes.
According to my view, I wanted to do bioscience. But for something or the other, I missed to go to the medical university, but I was lucky enough to enter the University of Colombo and to complete my degree in biological science. So that is at that one place they allowed me to do what I wanted me to do, and they knew and they had trust on me that I will never go wrong.
As a secretary, I'm dealing with the top management, so they are giving a task in a time frame, so we have to complete all the work in a given time frame. So it is very important factor to manage our time.
From the moment we wake up and until we go to sleep, we work hard to achieve our goals. But the question is, what does these goals do to take us to our dream destinations? Setting goals will give us a clear focus and clear directions to reach our destinations. So, the goal settings can be important to personal goals and also for the organizational goals. So, in general, I would like to talk about the benefits of goal setting.
I have with me Sandra tonight. How are you feeling?
Hi, I'm feeling great. I'm excited and waiting for the event to unfold.
Right. So what is your, what are you most excited for tonight?
I think it's when the professional secretaries, literally the ladies and the gentlemen who run the offices for the big bosses in town, get together to celebrate their achievements and socialize. And also there is an event, a contest, in which they are selecting the best or the secretary of the year, you know, which I'm very excited to be judging and so excited to be a part of it. After all, it is the Sri Lanka Association of Professional Secretaries, and they do such a wonderful job to keep all of the organizations in Sri Lanka. It's like the woman or man behind, you know, the scene. So I think it's a good time for us to get together, celebrate them and celebrate their achievements and support them.
Technology has pretty much taken over our entire lives, from the way we live, to the way we work, to the way we think. If you, for example, if we think back, any of you all had a pen pal? There was a time we used to have a pen pal. We used to write with some strange friend across continents, exchange letters, be so excited to receive a letter from another country, wait to write them back. But now we communicate through Instagram, Facebook, Skype, video calls, online chatting. So yes, it has become pretty easy. Everyone is like in within reach, within seconds. But is there something about technology that we need to be concerned of?
I thank my God each time I think of you, and when I pray for you, I pray with joy. I was a chorister, but I worked hard for that. What is my smart work for that?
I have with me Maharuf. How are you feeling today?
I'm feeling very well, thank you. I was just all the way from Gaul, covering the test match, so a bit tired, but I'm looking forward to the event today.
So what are you most excited for from tonight?
I think in every field, recognition is very important. So I reckon tonight somebody will get recognized. And it's a competitive field. Any field what we are in, it's a competitive field. So whoever wins it will be recognized for future endeavors. So I'm actually very happy to be here and on invitation to judge who's going to be the next winner of SLAPS.
I have with me Sachindra. How are you feeling today?
It's really good, and I'm looking forward to hearing some really good speeches by the candidates today.
So can you speak about SLAPS and its significance with ICTA and the digital field?
So in terms of SLAPS and the profession, especially in terms of the tech field and digital field, it's important that the professional association skills and upskills these individuals to be able to be conversant with the digital skills that are required for this day and age, especially with things like chatbots, ChatGPT, and many intelligent tools. We bring in those human values when we are a professional secretary, and that is really important in terms of the digital dispersion of this country, that everyone is in par, and that's why such upskilling is important.
Right, Miss Fox, I'd like to invite you now to go ahead and hand over the first copy of your book to the president of SLAPS, Miss Azra Rialdeen.
I have with me Jennifer. How are you feeling today?
I feel great today.
So can you speak a little bit about the history of SLAPS and your role in it and how it was to be president and a couple of projects that you chaired?
Okay. SLAPS started in 1978, okay, with a few secretaries, but then it built up. We had a tremendous encouraging founder, Eric B.M. De Silva. Started out from there, and I took over as president in 1995, and I carried on 1996. And during my presidency, we had this particular event that we are running today, Secretary of the Year, as a part of the Secretary's celebration, International Secretary's celebration, which is the last week of April. It's international, okay? So we run a one-week program here, and now we are just picking up again. So this is one event. We have a flag day, and we also have a seminar that follows. But today is our day because today is fellowship day for the secretaries. Usually the secretaries' day comes on a Wednesday, but we have taken it down for Friday this year. And I'm looking forward to a wonderful evening because we're having this contest. The last time we had it was in 2014, and our current president was the Secretary of the Year. Okay, so we're having it now after so long, and I'm just looking forward to a tremendous evening with lots of fellowship and lots of friends and lots of new things and new beginnings. Yeah.
So speaking of new beginnings, I heard that the month of May is very important to you, that you're co-authoring a book. Would you like to speak a little bit about that?
I just brought the book because I want to present it to my president. It's the book Me No Pause. Right, and I've co-authored it. There are 19 authors on this book. I'm one of them, spanned in seven countries. It's actually a book on empowerment, true life stories of all the 19 authors. And we hope that we are going to have tremendous sales, I would say. It's now available on Amazon.com. And let's hope how it'll pick up.
Secretary of the Year 2023 is Chaturini Karyavasam. I'd also like to invite Ms. Ruchira Abewardhana to present the certificate and the wonderful basket of flowers as well to our winner once again, Ms. Chaturini Karyavasam, for that rousing speech she gave today, a rousing presentation. Right. In addition to that, you have a lot more to take home with you. Miss Sandra De Soysa will be awarding you a pendant. Mr. Faviz Maharoof will be awarding you a gift courtesy of Noritake. And Mr. Sachin De Samaratna will be awarding you a special voucher as well. Miss Chaturini, you certainly have your hands full as today's winner, this year's winner of the Secretary of the Year 2023 competition.
Chaturini, Secretary of the Year 2023. How are you feeling today? How does it feel to be the winner?
I'm feeling so happy and feeling so proud.
So how long have you been part of SLAPS? How has the journey been so far?
This is my first time, so I'm so excited.
I hope you have a great night.
Yeah, you too.
The Honorable Secretary of SLAPS. We'll start with Niroshi Abe Dira. You may come up and collect your certificate. Next, I'd like to call upon Ms. Duminda Guruwatha, please. How about it for Ms. Nilupuli Gunawardhana? And finally, Ms. Dumindra Jayawardhana, please join us on stage. Now, be presenting a special token of appreciation to be presented to our judges. How about it, ladies and gentlemen? Put your hands together for the beautiful Miss Fox, please.
This event is held to mark the International Secretaries Week, which is celebrated worldwide in the last week of April. and we eagerly anticipate this great occasion to meet our colleagues as well as the new entrant. You will be enlivened to witness the five finalists who will take part in the Viva competition of the Secretary of the Year 2023. We also have organized many exciting games for you. And Queen of the Night and the selection of the best attire are a few exciting moments for you.
Your Slaps Queen for the year 2023, Nilupuli Gunawardana!
With me, Nilupuli, Slaps Queen of the year 2023. How are you feeling today?
I'm feeling great.
Right. How does it feel to be the Slaps Queen?
Actually, this is an unexpected moment, but actually I'm enjoying it. So I'm so grateful for this moment.
So how long have you been part of Slaps and how has the experience been so far?
Actually, I'm a newest member of the Slaps, so I'm enjoying this membership so far. It's fun.
Hope you have a really good night.
Yes, I'm already having a good night.
And that's a wrap. Nisrigur Singha signing off.